What I thought is I will brief you about careers in public health management as I see it now and how they will emerge and what kinds of careers people from our institute have taken up and some basic understanding of public health and management. Can I have the next slide? So public health is quite an old subject, and if you look at history of public health, it goes back to thousands of years, where not very far from Ahmedabad there is a Harappan site called Lothal, which has a very interesting and very well laid out drainage system for taking out the dirty water from people's homes towards away from the village. And this is 2500 years BC, so almost 4000 years, 4,500 years ago. Unfortunately, we all lost that in the death of the Harappan civilization. So hygiene and sanitation was a very important concept in Harappan civilization. If you look at Ayurveda, there are concepts of prevention and remaining healthy. So the whole science of health is what is Ayurveda, and it is full of various kinds of therapies, various kinds of daily practices which will keep you healthy. Then when the British came, and as we are still struggling with the COVID epidemic, we are reminded by the government, most of the government actions and orders emanate from the British era Epidemic Act of 1897. And the Britishers came, they developed the infrastructure for public health, then the legal infrastructure, they set up the Indian Institute of Hygiene and Public Health and the Institute of Tropical Medicine in Calcutta, following the London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine. You might know that Colonel Ronald Ross, a British colonel, British Army colonel, came to India and worked here to discover how malaria is transmitted from mosquitoes to humans, and in the whole cycle of malaria he worked out and won the Nobel Prize for his work in public health in 1905. And Indian Medical Service and public health officers maintained the hygiene and health conditions in the cities of India under the British. And British periodically sent sanitary commissions to India to see what is the sanitary conditions here and how to reform it so that the Indian society and the British soldiers and officers could remain healthy in those years. So that was the beginning and short history of public health in India. Can we move to the next slide? Yeah. If you look at now global public health, how it is defined, there are many definitions, and Dr. Zsolt can throw more light on that. But practically, it is the art and science of preventing disease, prolonging life, and organizing health services so that everybody remains healthy and has access to care as and when they are needed. So public health is really a multidisciplinary subject. Here there is a 7 or 8 spoke or main activities of health. For example, surveillance. This COVID epidemic, that has become like test, trace, and treat is the motto of COVID control. That is, surveillance is the first thing, then monitoring, analysis, outbreak control, disease prevention, communication, emergency preparedness, recovery, environmental health, research, and health promotion. So these are the key functions of public health. And if you see on the right-hand side, you will see what kinds of now modern public health has what kinds of various health hazards and health problems it deals with besides the infectious diseases and epidemics and pandemics. So this art and science of public health expands and cover many fields of science, arts, humanities, commerce, and other fields. Next slide, please. So So the programs we offer, and this is I'm focusing on Indian Institute of Public Health, but in general, all the public health institutes of the PHFI family offer public health diploma. It's a postgraduate diploma in public health management, which is a 1 year full-time diploma. Initially started in 2008 for the government-sponsored candidates under the National Rural Health Mission as a promotional in-service training program. And later on, we also take private candidates in this program. This is a 1 year full-time program. Then we have started at several of our institutes, Master of Public Health, which is a 2 year full-time program being offered in Gandhinagar, Delhi, Hyderabad, and also in Shillong. And it has a 6 months practical work experience and internship. During those 2 years, we have also started Master of Hospital Administration as a 2 year full-time program. Delhi Institute also offers MSc and PhD in clinical research. We also run a 2 year, 2 3 month program called Associate Fellow in Industrial Health, which is for medical doctors. And as you saw, many e-learning and certificate courses are offered by the Public Health Foundation family of institutes. Can I go to the next slide? So basically, if you are interested in learning about public health and management of health services, what will you learn here? If you come to some of these programs, you will learn the basics of public health, which are subjects like epidemiology, biostatistics, national health program, infectious disease, and non-infectious disease. How they spread, how they can be controlled, how they can be managed in the community and public health side. So it is not a clinical training, but it is a public health training. Then you will learn subjects like organizational behavior, human resource management. It should be not research management, it's a type of management, I'm sorry. And health communication, program planning and management. So many subjects of management. And then health policy, health financing, health economics, health insurance, health legislation, and many other subjects which will help you to develop your overall career as well as your personality and your own self. So we try to make it a holistic program which is focused on public health management and hospital management, but helps improve your overall personality and your growth in your career. Next slide, please. Now I come to the scope of public health and hospital management. Where do our graduates have potential to work? So public health services is the first thing where they will work. As I said, many people come with the government background. They have worked in the government, in the primary health centers, community health centers, district hospitals, come for 1 year, and then join back the state service, the central health service, or at the city level as the deputy health officers. And in future, they will become district health officers and directors of public health. We also have people who join with us with paramedical background and are absorbed in the state government as program officers under the National Rural Health Mission project, where there are several positions at district level, state level, and also national level. Our graduates also find positions in National Health Systems Resource Centers, State Health Systems Resource Centers, and any such semi-government organizations and autonomous organizations linked to the government. Our students have also gone and worked in the NGOs in public health, working in public health and rural development. Many companies have now started their own foundation under the corporate social responsibility, and they absorb many public health people to work in various areas in the rural and urban underprivileged populations. Our students also join UN organizations like UNDP, which is a development program, UN UNICEF, which is for child health, WHO, which is the main lead agency for health among the UN family of organizations. our students also go in teaching and research, and they have joined as faculty or research staff in various institutes like TISS, IIM Ahmedabad, research organizations like ICMR, and other national importance organizations like JIPMER, Pondicherry, etc. Next slide, please. Many of our students also go to NGO and work there as community health officers or in the community health programs. They also, some of them start, get experience in an NGO and start their own public health NGO. Or they have also started hospital management consulting company. They may also initially join a hospital management or health management consulting company, get experience and develop their own consultancy services. There are international organizations like CARE, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, and others who have also taken our graduates to work for them. Most of these people work in areas where public health implementation happens in rural and remote areas. And in the hospital side, they work in various hospitals, in the hospital management and improving the care to the patients. Next slide. Our people work in hospital with the hospital management program, in government, corporate and NGO hospitals, in health insurance companies, in third party organizations, especially also in the Ayushman Bharat program, where they are providing health insurance to the bottom parts of our society. Many of our past students have gradually moved after 3 to 5 years of experience in the government or in an NGO setup or a research organization to move to international assignments here or abroad. So as you become senior, you are more likely to get international jobs in development sector, in public health sector. Next slide. The most commonly asked question in public health is, and Shaumik alluded to that, the starting salaries are between 25 to 35,000, but could go up to 1,25,000 depending upon your background and the kind of agency you are getting recruited in. So there is quite a bit of variation, but there is reasonably good salary. Plus, then you get a very rewarding type of work where you work with the rural communities, you see their life changing, you see their access to healthcare improving. Many of our students are working in rural areas of the most difficult parts of India, and I'll show you in some of the next slides. Next slide. One frequently asked question is what kind of background students can join public health management. So this is an interesting diagram prepared by our faculty to show that any branch of graduation, you can join public health. It is similar to Master of Business Administration. You need a basic degree, but most of our students come from medicine and allied subjects like Ayurvedic medicine, homeopathy, physiotherapy, dentistry. Some of them come from biological sciences, some from social sciences, some from management and commerce, and some from even engineering. I'll show you in next slides. Next slide, please. I just want to show you where our some of the past batch students have gone. So these are the students who have joined a year before now in World Health Organization, large surveillance medical officers, and helping improve the vaccination program and surveillance of diseases under WHO program in various countries. And if you see, any of them have either dentist or Ayurvedic graduates also. Next slide, please. These are some of the other students who have recently joined World Health Organization, again surveillance medical officers in UP, Bihar, MP, etc. Next slide. UNDP is also recruiting some of our students, especially because the vaccination program is now supported by UNDP, and they work as project officers to improve the vaccine management systems and vaccination program. And now with COVID vaccination coming in, many of them are working to improve the vaccination program so it can also work in the COVID vaccination. Next slide, please. Some of the people have been working with CARE in Bihar. CARE has a large program in Bihar supported by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, where they have various levels of positions at the public health implementation level, monitoring and evaluation level, data analysis, and technical support, etc., etc. And there are three, four batches of people who have now been working in CARE in Bihar. Next slide, please. Many industry-related foundation, and I'm just giving one example, Deepak Foundation is a foundation based in Gujarat, but working in many states through corporate social responsibility funding. And many of our students are now working with this in various parts of Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Maharashtra. Next slide. Now I show you some of the students who have from different backgrounds, because some of you may have different backgrounds. So these are our nursing students who have been working after graduation in many of the UN organizations, in hospitals, in home care settings, in project associates in our own organization for research and implementation projects. Next slide. These are people from social work background. Social work is a very good background to get into public health, because you are very much oriented to community work, case work, and you have prepared yourself to work in rural areas, and that gives you an edge for working in the various programs which are conducted in rural and remote areas. Next slide. These are students from engineering. Every year we get two, three to five students who have engineering backgrounds of various types, and they also get very interesting job opportunities, because engineers have a different set of skills, and with addition of public health, they can become good hospital managers, good program officers, project managers, and can contribute to public health and management in a great way. Next slide, please. Students of pharmacy have also worked with us or got graduated from our institutes and are working in many different organizations within the PHFI family and outside. Next slide. So this is students from general science background, many different types of background, biology, zoology, botany, biochemistry, molecular biology, life sciences, etc., have also come and become the public health graduates, and they work in the laboratory side as well as on the program management side. Next slide. This is also from general science background. People have been coming and working after MPH and MHA degree programs in various different fields. Next slide. So I'll not go into much detail, but even allopathy doctors, MBBS doctors are also coming, and they are doing very well in various national and international organizations. Next slide. Students from dentistry. Dentistry is a very popular branch. Mostly one third of our students come with that branch, and they become good hospital managers as well as work in various programs of company-based foundations or other foundations. Next slide. This is homeopathy stream students, which is also substantial proportion of students come from this background. Next slide. This is Ayurvedic, so all the Ayush background students are also important part of our student body. Next slide. These are from physiotherapy, which is another area which is popular to do NPH and MHA, because they are already working with hospitals and health sector, so they had a good background knowledge to become good public health people as well as hospital management personnel. Next slide. These are some of the just logos I am showing you where our students are placed in various organizations, companies, hospitals, National Health Authority, various institutions of higher learning, including research, ICMR, Indian Institute of Management, IQVIA, Narayan Health Services, etc. Next slide. These are also other industry related placements in NGOs, national and international organizations. Next slide. So I end here with some few shots of our newly built campus at Gandhinagar, which is a very modern campus built in 50 acres of land generously donated by Gujarat government, where we have built fully residential campus for students and very modern educational facilities. Thank you very much.